Well, time for part 11. And with any luck, this will finally be the last one. I've been working on this piece forever, for literal months. I think I started it back in March or something. Yeah, it's taken several hours. This face here is looking pretty good, so I'm gonna try and concentrate on the other face as much as I can. If I can even out this large flake scar just a little bit and get a better pressure flaking pattern on this face, that'd be great. All I really need to do is bring in the edge of the blade a little bit, get it more triangular. I have to move, I don't know if you can tell, but the tip here is a little bit off center. I think it's easier to tell from this, maybe. Yeah, anyways. It's off center. I gotta bring this in, but I'll do it on this face. So that's where I'm gonna get started. With any luck, I'll keep everything on camera. That'll do it. So I got my pressure flaker nice and dressed up. Just taking small flakes off the other flake. Off the other face to prepare a nice continuous platform to take good pressure flakes off of this face. Probably gonna have to sharpen my pressure flaker a few times during this process. Kind of work is pretty tough on it. Just eats through the material. Okay, so I'll start at the tip. Yeah, I need to bring the actual tip a little bit farther this way because right now it's a little off center. That's what I was trying to say before, but couldn't quite get there. Not getting the really nice flakes that I wanted to. It's pretty warm out today. I'm a little bit sweaty actually. Gonna move that tip over a bit more anyways, so. I can fix this spot up with any luck. And a big flake. Not too bad. There we go, that was a good one. Probably need a sharper pressure flaker than this actually for this job, but just gonna go with it. That ended up being a fairly decent pressure flaking sequence in the end. And it's getting closer to looking right. Not quite there yet. Gonna keep going down and try and get a nice pattern going. I think actually I'll start here and come back this way because because I don't have the greatest ridge to follow or the best platform yet, but I can make it better as I work towards it. I just need small flakes here. I can't take big ones into that large, flat, negative flake there. Flake scar. Okay, I think I can get a slightly better one here. Nice. That's not perfect, but I'm happy with it. The overall flake pattern at that spot, anyways. Now I'll work down towards the base. Won't be able to get rid of that, you know, all of that flake scar, but I can make it look slightly nicer anyways. That edge is looking better. Still gotta bring it in there some more near the tip. This might be a long video after all, but I am bound and determined to finish this today, hopefully. I think that tip is still a little too far that way. Yeah, gotta move it over some more. Hinge there, thumbnail hinge. Oh well. Wow, that was not great. Some messy looking flakes there. Oh well. Really should sharpen this pressure flaker now. I'll come from the other side of it. That's a good angle. Well, there's definitely more messing around that I could do with this, but I don't think I will. It's, yeah. I don't know. It's not perfect, but I'm pretty happy with it. I think it's looking pretty Dalton-like, you know, somewhat. The base here, oops, last time I did a Dalton, I made these side notches a lot longer. They were like, they went up to here probably, and they were a little deeper. I don't think I really need to do that with this piece. I quite like the base as it is. I think overall it'll look really cool with the serrations once I put them in, so I really need to sharpen up this pressure flaker for that. And then all I'm gonna do is just grind all the edges. I won't put in long flakes for these serrations, just, you know, one flake from one face, and then clean it up, separate the serrations nicely from the other face. And then that'll be that.
Yeah.
The abrasion I'm gonna do, I think. I'm gonna take a quick break and abrade, you know, dress up my pressure flaker, make it real nice, thin, sharp, with the cat hair everywhere, with a fine tip on it, and then I'll finish this up. Yeah, be right back. And away we go. It's about 20 minutes later. Had a nice little break, sharpened up my pressure flaker, abraded this a little more. So what I'm gonna do is take alternating flakes from either edge to try and make sure the serrations are lined up and things are somewhat balanced. And I'm hoping for a somewhat decent pressure flaking pattern on this face. And then this face will just be the small ones to fix everything up. So what I'll do is start at the tip, and yeah, I'm not gonna be, you know, playing around with the edges after I take the flakes off, because I want the, you know, this is the final round of flaking. Everything should be nice and sharp at the end of it. So yeah, here it goes. Sweaty again. That was a messy one. Well, this is a very long video, isn't it? But I think that went somewhat okay. I'm gonna go sharpen up my pressure flicker a little bit more and just, yeah, make everything nice and sharp and defined. Okay. Pressure flicker sharpened up. Eyes are focusing kind of in and out a little bit, but I'm doing all right. Yeah, so the face is looking pretty cool, I think. Pretty deadly. Now I just need to clean it up. Oops. Take tiny flakes from the other face in between these serrations. Trying to make sure everything's nice and sharp. Only take off as much as I need to. That was kind of messy, but. Well. All right, well, I wouldn't say that went perfectly, but it went pretty good, I think, overall. It's, you know, fairly sharp. It'll do some damage. Yeah, just a display piece for the winter anyways. Just looking at the bottom part here. And I think probably should even it out a little bit more, but I'm not gonna risk it at this point. Yeah, so this here is the presentation face. I think it looks pretty cool. Nice flaking pattern. You know, serrations look really sharp with the central ridges. This face looks a little bit, you know, duller. I don't know, for some reason it almost looks like came from a slab or something on this face because of those really, you know, abrupt angles with the short flakes just to accentuate those serrations. Anyways, yeah, so this is the front, the display side, display face. That's the back. Still pretty cool. The base is, you know, not a perfect Dalton, but it'll do. Pretty sharp looking. It could definitely do some damage. Okay, well, this video is a million hours long, so I'm gonna finish this up and I'll do a separate video where I'll do the actual auction and, you know, collect everyone's bids and everything. If you feel like placing a bid into this video, you know, underneath in the comment section, please go for it. But otherwise, probably in a few more days, there will be an official video where I auction off this point to the highest bidder. I'll probably do, I don't know, a week-long bidding or something like that. I don't know. Haven't quite worked out the details yet. This will be the first time I'm doing something like that, so yeah, we'll see how it goes. All right, well, that's it for this one. As always, thanks for watching. Catch you next time. Cheers.